Israel, you were promised the Savior. O Son of God, come to us and ransom us from our lonely exile. The choir will sing, O come, Emmanuel.
Glory to God in the highest. Christmas morn. Peace on earth and tidings of great joy.
For unto you this night a child is born. For unto you this night a child is born.
In the fields, shepherds saw the glory of the angelic host, who sent them to find the child laying in a manger, wrapped in swaddling clothes. Born there in the stable was the King of heaven and earth. The choir was singing, Vat Minuet. This newborn king can be found in the town of David, the town called Bethlehem. Join us in singing, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Above thy dear.
on this holy night, we have left our homes to come and worship the Savior. Heavenly hosts, saying hallelujah, for peace comes to us through this holy infant sleeping in the arms of Mary. Join us in singing the silent night.
Angels singing,
no one's ringing,
but oxen lowing, little knowing, Christ the baby is Lord of all.
Swift are winging, angels singing,
Thank you. angels and friends and adore you, crying out to the angels, glory to God in the highest and on earth peace and good hope to all. We glorify you, your Father, and your Holy Spirit forever.
Oh,
Let me then praise you with purity and listen to your holy scriptures. To you be glory forever.
Amen. For today is an infant, wonderful and mighty God, in a wonderful manner, as a child of
you
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
From the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to St. Luke, who proclaimed light to the world, let us listen to the proclamation of light and salvation for our souls.
Remain silent, listeners, for the Holy Gospel is about to be proclaimed to you. Listen and give glory and thanks to the word of the living God.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that the whole world should be enrolled. This was the first census when Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to be enrolled, each to his own town. And Joseph too went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth to Judea, to the city of David that is called Bethlehem. Because he was of the house of David and the family of David, to be enrolled with Mary, his wife, who was with child. While they were there, the time came for her to have her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Now there were shepherds in that region, living in the fields and keeping the night watch over their flock. The angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were struck with great fear. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I proclaim to you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For today in the city of David, the Savior has been born to you, who is Messiah and Lord. And this shall be a sign for you. You shall find an infant wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was a multitude of the heavenly host with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to those on whom his favor rests." When the angels went away from them to heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go then to Bethlehem to see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went in haste and found Mary and Joseph and the infant lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known the message that had been told them about this child. All who heard it were amazed by what had been told by the shepherds. And Mary kept all these things, reflecting on them within her heart. This is the truth. Peace. This is the truth. Peace be with you.
Praise and blessings to Jesus Christ, our Lord and God.
Let us go up over to Bethlehem to see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has made known to us. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. We have, over the weeks of the announcements, always seen this continual unveiling of God's message through Zechariah, through the Blessed Virgin Mary, through Elizabeth, through all of these individuals, and finally to Joseph being pushed into that adoption of the Messiah. We've always come to this ultimate revelation, this ultimate announcement in which the child himself, the Word of God, is born into this world. The Word enters in order to transform us. This we know. We know the basic, we know the story. We all know the story. We've all seen Charlie Brown. We all know what is done. So the question becomes when and who and what is actually happening.
So this evening, let us move a little bit beyond Charlie Brown and the talking puppets. When does this take place? It's in the reign of Caesar Augustus, who reigns between the year 27 BC and the year 1480. The beauty of Christianity, as I mentioned to you numerous times, is this is the only religion on the world upon which we can point to historical dates. All of the pagan religions are once upon a time stories. Islam, you can point, yet Muhammad existed. But even in the old law, Mount Sinai with Moses, we do not have a precise date. We have rough centuries of when this took place. But St. Luke gave us distinctly the governors, the high priests, the emperor's names, so that we have the year 2017 because we can calculate when the Word of God entered into time to transform time, to transform human life, and to reunify the unity between the human race and God. So who is actually then appearing? We are told that Mary brings forth her firstborn son. And many will hear that in English and they'll think firstborn, therefore there's others. We know as Catholics, of course, but there are others. And what they miss is that when we speak about the firstborn son, Decorum in the law, the firstborn, is a legal title belonging to this child under the law of Moses, as recounted in the book of Exodus and the book of Numbers. This is legal obligations and legal honors to this child born, regardless of any other children ever coming after it. So when it says that she brings forth her firstborn son, we are establishing his legal status in Israel as the son of Israel. That God, the eternal Word, enters into time as a member of the people of Israel. And not just simply as a member, but as a Bechor, as a firstborn among these. For all those who remember your Lebanese Situs, having the firstborn grandson, firstborn son, you know those stories. When I was in Fall River, there was a lady, she married late. She was in her 30s when she married. Beautiful marriage. But she only had one child. Beautiful child. It was a daughter. And she tells me as she went to what was Fall River's equivalent of Heather Falls, with her beautiful little baby girl, all the lovely Lebanese ladies in the Fall River said, "Better luck next time." Now, to our American ears, it sounds unusual. This is an ancient tradition, and in this instance, it is clearly the law of Moses, which is being recounted of this firstborn, Bechor, the firstborn son. And of course, this child is born in the house, Beit Lechem. We say Bethlehem, but it's Beit Lechem, the house of bread, because he is the divine bread who comes down from heaven to give us life. And obviously, transformation in Beit Lechem, the house of bread, because the child himself is laid in a feeding trough, so that we can come and ultimately receive from this divine child and live. The third point that I'd like you to consider is what is happening here. We know the angel. We almost missed our angel. We would have been able to put him up higher, but we only found him this afternoon to bring him out. So he's kind of on the side. And just unfortunately, we live in the Western world, so the angels only speak Latin. And so he's holding the banner, glory in his chest is big, which is so lovely. You know the story, so you can translate it. So what is happening when the Father's comment, that when we have in Genesis creation made, and there is light created, the fathers of the church comment that this is not light like we have in this building, because the sun is not created until the fourth day. But it is the angels of God, the spirits, what we call in the Syriac tradition the watchers, those who are pure intelligence who watch all creation in themselves and in the vision of God within the divinity. And they sing of the glory of the creation that is taking place. And so as the Father's comment of the old creation of nature, that the spirits, that the launchers sing to the glory of that creation, so as the firstborn is brought into this world, for the new creation of the human race, so the angels of God again sing of the new creation, not just simply the first creation. And so, what I'll leave you with is the consideration of what the shepherds do. In the singing of the angels, we have something very clearly given to the people of Israel. As far as we know, and we can easily presume, the shepherds themselves are Israelites. They are Jews. They're in the fields. But they are given through intelligent beings the knowledge of the birth of the Messiah. The non-Israelites, the Magi, will be shown through a non-rational, non-intelligent entity, which is the star. And probably a year or two later they come. That's a different sermon. We see them all together on the Christmas cards, but clearly in the Gospel they don't all show up on the same night. And so this intelligence which is given to the shepherds, remember what their sign is. You're going to find a baby. Seeing a baby is not a sign. We all have all seen babies and nothing necessarily divine about them. Cute baby, but not divine. So what they give as the sign is that this baby is going to be bottled up as a newborn and laying in a feeding trough. Now that's a little bit different. You don't usually find them in the animal's troughs. And you notice that what the shepherds do is they say, let's go to Bethlehem to see this thing that's been announced, if it's true. Because we're told by St. Luke, when the shepherds arrive in this cave, they find this shelter for animals. They do find a child in the feeding trough. Then we are told by St. Luke, then they recount what they have been told. Remember that in that cave, Mary and Joseph hadn't seen any of this take place. Again, our Christmas cards make it all in the same scene. The shepherds are a good mile and a half out when all this takes place. They come in, they recount to Mary and Joseph what has been told to them. And one of the marvelous things that we have is that Joseph and Mary marvel at this. This is something which they see the message being spread of what they are aware of, but they see it now being given to those outside. And in that marveling, the shepherds then wind up leaving. And when they go out, we are told they tell everyone what happened that night. They recount what they have seen, they recount what they have been told. But in the midst of all of it, what is beautiful is we are told that Mary kept all of these things within her heart. Remember, as I told you earlier these weeks, that St. Luke is the only one who tells us the stories of the infancy. And it is almost absolutely certain that he gives them directly from the recounting of the mother of God. And we're told not only that she tells the story, as every mother can tell the story of their children's lives, but it is a source of contemplation for her, that she meditates, she keeps them within her heart. And to leave you with the last thought for Christmas, that Mary and Joseph don't see anything about the angels. They are left in silence with the baby and the feeding trough in a less than agreeable place to be. When God's grace works in our lives, we ourselves can often be left in silence. It would be nice that every time in our lives there were angels singing point the next step we have to do, or the next thing we have to start for another chapter of our lives. And this doesn't happen. But what we see in the story of Bethlehem is that the individuals who are closest to this child being born, the divine word, they are left in silence, and they are told by others of the glory that appears. And that is the source of their contemplation. Their meditation. Grace speaks in silence. The moments of glory of the angels are beautiful. We celebrate them annually. But the other 364 days, grace is silent. But we have Mary and Joseph as an example of a life which is contemplative, thoughtful, conscious, meditative, and in doing so, in following the path of God. May their intercession give us strength to do the same, to enter into the divine light of this Word incarnate, and in so doing, find healing, strength, and ultimately the vision of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Hello.
Almighty Lord and God, you accepted the offerings of our ancestors. Now accept these offerings that your children have brought to you under their love for you and for your holy name. Shower your spiritual blessings upon them, and in place of the earthly gifts, grant them life and your kingdom.
Amen.
As you are for our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ, in this plan of salvation for us, we recall upon this offering all those who have pleased God from Adam to this day, especially Mary, the Blessed Mother of God, Saint Joseph of Scots, Saint Mary, Saint Jude, and Saint Chardin. Remember, O God, the children of the Holy Church, our fathers and mothers and our brothers and sisters, both the living and the departed, especially those for whom the sacrifice is offered, for the intentions of the members of this parish, and for those of the Catholic Extension Society and its donors. Remember also all those who share with us today in this offering.
Amen.
The glory and honor of the Most Holy Trinity. We burn this incense. Hear ye this.
Peace that was meant to be. Rejoice,
Love, sir.
Maria, mega seum et ira. Hosoio, haume no hoi, na vana plenni.
Our souls and bodies, a body that purifies us of all sin for eternal.
Thank you.
O Lord, our Lord, who sent us your only Son, who is the radiance of your eternity, and he accomplished his plan of salvation for us, that we may come to you. May we call upon you with that prayer, and taught his holy disciples to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, and power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Sing in chorus. one day walk on water. Did you know that your baby boy will save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to thank you too? The child that you deliver will soon deliver him. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy has walked where the angels trod? When you kiss your little baby, you kiss the face of God. Mary, did you know the blind will see, the deaf will hear, the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, the praises of the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy is Lord of all creation? Did you know that your baby boy will one day rule the nation? Did you know that your baby boy is heaven's perfect plan? The sleeping child you're holding is the grave I am.
Divine Christ. Lord, you this good faith and faith and charity is only blind and the top of salvation. How can we repay you for your gift, your grace, and your forgiveness? Ask for this almost to approach this life to be negative and as worthy that your body and your will is of our bodies and your blood of our soul.
God the Father, we bow before you and entrust ourselves to your care. We ask you in glory and in mercy to rest your right hand full of blessings upon us. Assist us, protect us, bless us, and sanctify us by the cross of your only Son. We glorify and honor you, your only Son, and your Holy Spirit, now and forever.
Amen.
So again, we wish you all a very blessed and merry Christmas. And the abundance of God's graces is coming in the year. Please be careful that as you go home tonight on all the icy roads, we celebrate Christmas, we don't want funerals. Go in peace, my beloved brothers and sisters, with the nourishment and the blessing you have received from the forgiving altar of the Lord. May the blessing of the Most Holy Trinity accompany you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the one God, to whom be glory forever.
Nature sing.